Hello Year 6 and welcome to Ulverston Victoria High School.
VHS. Now, normally, we'd be inviting you into school at the moment to do some taste lessons, to meet some of the key staff, and to generally find out about the school, find out where the toilets are, the canteens, the sports field, and begin to feel at home. Now, obviously, we can't do that at the moment because of the current situation. So, we will be inviting you to Paris in September, but for now, this video is to give you a bit of a flavour of the school, and sort of set your mind at rest about some of the things that you might be worried about. Thank you, and I'll see you in September.
As many of you know, my name is Mr. Butler, and I'm the assistant head teacher in charge of all the new students coming into Year 7 every year. It's my job to make you feel as happy and safe as possible when you come to the school. Now, obviously with coronavirus, we've not been able to do all the transition activities that we'd normally do. So what we're going to do here is give you a virtual tour of the school. This is the most important place in the school. We have reception, where if you've got any problems at all, you can just go and ask them for help. We have Mr. Hardwick's office, who you've just heard from. We have the main hall as well. Okay, so as we said, here is reception. If you've got any problems at all whilst you're in school, whether you get lost, whether you've lost your planner, whether you're not sure where you've got to go for your next lesson, if you've lost any paperwork, if you're handing in official documents, all you need to do is come to the office here. Also, if you're feeling ill during the school day, someone will come and collect you from your class and you'll be brought here to be seen by one of our first aiders. So what we're going to do now is have a look around this block, which is A block. As we go down the corridor, we have stairs up to science, which are just up here. There are three sets of stairs, which you'll see on the maps. And then we work further along, and we're coming into the maths department. So there are 10 maths rooms, A1 to A10. But the most important room for you is just here. And this is where your head of year, Mrs. Hayton, has her office.
I'll be on the year in September. I'm really looking forward to meeting you. I know I've seen and spoken to a few of you before the lockdown, and I've been bringing in this summer, and I really am looking forward to being here and meeting you and your families in September. This is my office. It's in the main building, really easy to find, but if I'm not here, I'll be found over in the sports hall, because I'm a PE teacher, and I'll be there when I'm teaching, so I'll either be here or in the sports hall. Now, I know a few of you will be really worried about coming here in September. We haven't been able to do a normal transition, but please don't worry, you won't get lost. Every single building is sandboarded, and Mr. Butler's going to show you around school and just take it in. You're not expected to know where everything is. I didn't when I started. But everybody's really friendly, and everybody's here to help you. Staff will help you, the older kids, regardless of what people say to you, they will really help you. And so please don't worry about getting lost. I've got a really wonderful team of form teachers to help you in September. So you'll all have your own form teacher. They will be the person that you see every morning and every afternoon, and they will be answering all your questions, and they're really, really, really good. They'll work closely with me. And what extra you've got is you've got a peer mentor. So each form will have two peer mentors from year 10 to support you on your journey through year 7. They'll be in your form rooms, they'll be around at breaks and lunch times, and they'll be there to answer your questions. So if you don't want to speak to a teacher, you can speak to your peer mentor. I've been really lucky that I've been able to speak to your primary schools just to get a little bit more information about you. So please don't worry, we know as much as we possibly can. And I'm really looking forward to meeting you in September. With the journey through year 7 and right through to the end of year 11, to make us as happy as possible for you to be at school.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Hayton. Okay, so if we carry on, the maths corridor extends all the way down there, so when you have maths, it'll always be in this part of the building. And if we carry on down the corridor, we come to another really important room, the boys' toilets. So, if you're in A block, you need a toilet, this is where you would come. What we're going to do, however, is go through to south block now. So we go out the doors, under the covered way, and through into south block through these doors. Okay, so this is south block. Downstairs in south block, we have geography, history, and BPE. And upstairs, we have modern languages. Now, when you come into year seven, most of you will be studying French and German. You will do that through year seven and year eight. And at the end of year eight, you get the option to take up Spanish alongside French and German, or instead of one or both of those languages. Okay, so at the other end of the geography, history, BPE corridor, we've got another exit. It's gonna take us back outside, either to A block, or alongside the back of the school. We're going to go into A block and have a look at music and drama. Okay, so we're coming out of south block now, back into A block, and it'll be back onto the maths corridor, just at the bottom end. And as we can see, we're just now at the bottom of the corridor that we saw the top of before. Straight on into the music and drama corridor. Okay, so we're here now on the music and drama corridor. We've got various rooms going off to the side here, which are music practice rooms, if you have instrumental lessons, things like that, as well as music teaching rooms. And through here, we have the drama studio, where a lot of you will have your lessons, and we do some productions as well. And then, if we carry on further down, we come to my office. Now you will need to know where this office is, as well as Mrs. Hayton's, because I work with Mrs. Hayton throughout year seven, looking after your health and your safety. So this is my office here. And then if we just go around the corner, we have more or less the end of the music corridor, just here. Okay, so I've come down the music corridor now to the end of it, and I've ended up in the cloister. This is a brilliant area. We use it for many different things. It can be used at break time and lunchtime for you to meet your friends if the weather's not so good outside. We also use it for queuing up to go into lunch, and sometimes we'll have small tutorial lessons to help with English and maths sometimes here as well during your form times. What we're going to do though is show you where we queue up and how to get into lunch, if you can't remember from when you were in year five on the taster days. So we queue up down here, and then we walk through into the dining room. And here we have it, coming into now the dining room. And when we have lunch times, we have a sitting system so that year nines come in first, and then year sevens and eights take it in turns for who comes after that. You'll see we've got two counters for food, lots and lots of choice for you, and it's all paid for on parent pay using your thumbprints, which you've all had details about. So, we're back in the cloister again, having come through the dining room. What we're going to do now is go across to C block, centre block, which is where English is taught, where the library is, and where Townland's learning support is. So, follow me. Now, here we have C block, the entrance to all the English classrooms. We can have a look down some of those English classrooms now. And we also have two sets of stairs taking us up to the library, one at this side of the building and one at the other end. There are also toilets in this building as well. If you look at your transition booklet, you'll see exactly where those toilets are. Okay, we're now going to go round to the other side of C block, which is the newer side, and this is where Townland Learning Support is. Upstairs we also have the Sixth Form Resource Centre. coming into the other side of C Block now, and if we turn right here, we're going in to Townlands, which is where all the learning support is. And I think Mrs. Hillman might want to say a few words to you.
Hello, I'm Miss Hillman. I'm a Senko at UVHS, and this is the Townlands building, which Mr. Butler will have shown you on your tour. In here we have the classrooms C6 to C8, and some of you will be coming here for normal lessons, usually English and Maths, but sometimes some other things as well. We also do a few other things in here too, so this is a place where you could come at break and lunchtime if you're a bit worried about anything and wanted to do a club or make some new friends or have some company at lunchtime. And you could also come here for Homework Club, which runs every lunchtime and every after school, where there are members of staff who are able to help you with your homework, and we have things like computers and printers and lots of resources to help you do that. Sometimes people come here for extra sessions of different subjects or to work with a key worker. And anybody who's worried because they have diabetes or they need to take medication, then this is the place where we would keep that for you and where you would come to take that when you need it.
Okay, so we're still in C Block. We've just come up the stairs from Townlands. We're going to take a look in the library. Now then, the library is used for a lot of things. It's open from 8:05 in the morning, so that if you're on the train, you can come in and you can be getting on with some homework, chatting to your friends. Likewise, the dining room's actually open at that time as well for breakfast. You can also come up here at lunch times to do homework, and you can also come after school to do homework as well. Sometimes, some of your teachers will bring you in here for lessons when they want to use computers and they've not got access to other computer rooms. But as you can see, there's lots of resources here as well for you to use. Okay, so we're going to leave C Block behind us now, and we're going to walk around to the sports hall and the gym. As you can see, we've got lots of playing fields. We've got lots of recreational area outside as well for you to sit with your friends at lunchtimes and breaks. So here we are at the sports hall. Everyone will be doing PE either in here or in the gym, which is next door, similar layout. So if we go inside, we've got toilets again. We have the changing rooms for the boys and the girls just up here on my right. And then if we go in, we can have a look at the sports hall. Now, PE lessons in the school are split between indoor and outdoor, and you usually do 5 or 6 weeks indoor PE and then 5 or 6 weeks outdoor PE. You'll always be told what kit you need to bring with you, whether you need to bring football boots, outdoor PE kit, or indoor PE kit. And I said the gym is just next door. Okay, we're going to go round now to technology. So just down the side from the sports hall, we have the D block, which is for all technology and art. This is one of the entrances, and this gets us to D1 and D2, which is textiles and then various different technology subjects. If we go around the corner, we get access to the rest of the building, which will involve resistant materials, art, ICT, as well as all the CAD/CAM work that we do. Okay, if we come around the side of D block, we see the entrance to D4 and D5, which are the two food rooms. Now, when you're in year 7 and year 8, you'll be on a rota throughout the year of all the different technology subjects. You'll get a chance to do everything over year 7 and then again over year 8. And at the end of year 8, you then get some options for what you would like to specialise a bit more in. And here we are in the rest of the D block. So down this corridor, we have art rooms on the left-hand side and at the end, and we've got a computing room on the right at the end, and then we have all our design technology rooms, all the CAD/CAM work on the room on the right. What we're now gonna do is we're at the more or less the end, we're going to go to N block, see what's there, and then all the way back to A block where we started. Okay, so this is N block at the other end of school from S block, North block. Upstairs here, we have computer science and ICT, and we also have a few English and BB lessons that can't fit in the English block or in South block. Now those are all upstairs. We have computer science here as well. What you mustn't do, however, is go into the downstairs room here. As it says in The Lion King, everything the light touches is our land. If we go through those doors, that's the sixth form common room, and we don't want to go there. We're back in A block again now, more or less at the end of the tour. So let's take you down this corridor. In this part of A block, all the rooms are offices. So we have a deputy head teacher, assistant head teacher offices, we have the prim room. On the right, we have a corridor, another corridor down to the dining rooms. Now, this is the way you can come out of the main dining room, but not go in. However, it's the way your 10s and 11s do go into their lunch. And then if we carry on, we have the finance office. Now, if you've got any queries at all about money, whether it's for school lunches, whether it's payments for trips, this is where we can come and ask those questions. And if you've got cash on you that needs to be put into school, we've just got a letterbox that it goes in there. And then, if we carry on down, we come to the other set of science stairs. At the beginning of the tour, we showed you the first set, this is the second. We're going to nip upstairs and have a look around. Okay, so here we are on the science corridor now. Rooms A15 through to A28 are all science labs. You'll be coming here for your physics, chemistry, and biology. Now, in years 7 and 8, they're taught is what we call combined science, where it's on a rota which subject you are doing at the time. However, once we hit year 9, you'll get double lessons in each of the three sciences, as you will in year 10 and year 11 as well. What we're going to do is carry on around the corridor, because at the end of this corridor, we also have a really important room which you're all going to use at some point in year 7, and that's the engagement centre. And here we are at one end of the science corridor, and here we have the engagement centre. Now the engagement centre is totally focused on your social and emotional well-being whilst you're in the school. Beginning of year 7, you will all come here for us to make sure that you're feeling as happy and safe as you can be under the circumstances of starting school and also with coronavirus having happened as well.
Hello, welcome to the Engagement Centre, Augusta Victoria. I'm Mrs. Douglas.
Hi, Mrs. Butler, hello.
And our job is to make sure that when you come to school, you're in a really good place that you can learn as much as you can. So we're the safe place that you come to the school. And we're here all day from 8:30 to 3:30. You can make a break if you have a problem, or you can tell your teacher and they'll help you get to find us here.
Well, here at lunchtime, there's quite a few children, especially younger children in the school, that come and access this room at lunchtime. It's quite a fun place. We have some jigsaws and games that people might like to play, especially if you find yourself on your own. This is a good place to come and you can sit with us for lunch. We're also here if you have any kind of problem, really. We'll try and help you with that, and if we can't, we'll find a man or anything who can.
And that's more or less the end of the tour. We're just going to nip back downstairs to reception now. So, here we are, back where we started the tour. I hope you've enjoyed that quick little look around. Now, when we do get you into school on your transition days, on first day of term, we will give you a face-to-face tour of the school again, and probably actually once more after that, so you can start to get to know your surroundings and feel safe and happy in this new environment. But all that's left for me to say is, we really look forward to the next 5 years with you. We hope you're gonna love being at UVHS. We hope you take advantage of all the activities that are on offer, Joe, both inside and outside the classroom. This is really an amazing school, and we really look forward to seeing you. Bye.